60 unit, very very small 60 unit is okay. First 5 units are complex and vast topics they are having. So 60 unit is very small unit, only 4-5 topics are there in 60 unit. So 60 unit is mining different kinds of data. So data is different types in real world. In real world, the data is in different types, in different varieties. Various formats of data is there. So how you will mine different kinds of data? So that is the 60 unit, mining different types of data, different kinds of data. So how you will mine different kinds of data? That you will see in 60 unit. Okay. So first one is time series and sequence data, mining time series and sequence data. What is meant by time series data? Sequence data, time series and sequence data is, that is related to time. Okay, so the real time application, we can say the supermarket itself, no? So for which time it started, for 10 a.m. it started, okay, night at 10 p.m. it closed, it will close during the time 12 hours, at each and every hour, each and every minute, what are the transactions are going on? Okay, in database is updating. Database is updating it for every second. For every second, the database is updating. Then what you will get? Huge amount of data you will get in the real time, real world. You will get a huge amount of data related to time. So, our bank transactions, if you take in, if you take anything, hospital database, any database you take. The time related data is very vast, huge amount of data stored for every second, that is time related, regarding time. Okay, considering time, you can observe lot of amount of data, of data stored in the databases, data warehouses daily. Okay, so then how to mine the data, how to mine the time series data. So this huge amount of data is extracting is not an easy task. It is not a simple task. We have to follow some procedure. For time series data, we have to follow some procedure. What is meant by time series data? What is meant by this time series and sequence data? That we will see. So how we will extract the data? So how we will analyze the data? So how we have to reduce the data also. It is vast data. We have to reduce the data for mining. Why? Because from the plenty of data, if you extract the data, you have to search the entire data warehouse. That's why what you have to do, you have to reduce the data. You have to transform the data that is appropriate for mining. These all are needed for time series data mining. Okay, time related data mining. For that, we have to need all these. For that, we have to go through all these. So, a time series database consists of sequences of values or events obtained over repeated measurements of time. For every 2 minutes, we are having a sequence of values. For any database, we have taken the shopping mall or supermarket, just to take, for every 2 minutes, the sequence of plenty of values will come. Number of customer transactions are there in every 2 minutes. No? The values are typically measured at equal interval, equal time intervals. That is hourly, daily, weekly. The values measurements can be done within hour, how many transactions, within this, within day, within week, within month, like that. How many transactions are there? So just you combine 4 weeks, that will be the month data. Combine 3 months, that will give the quarter data. Combine quarters, that will give the year data, like that. Time series databases are popular in many applications, such as, see here, time series data is applicable in many, many ways. The main application is stock market analysis. You can see daily, every second, the stock market will face many fluctuations. So minor changes is not observed in stock market. Okay, so in seconds also, for a very small amount of time also, you can observe lot of changes. You can observe huge changes in stock market. In the same way, observation of natural phenomena, the temperature, the earthquake, the environment, that is the atmosphere. So these all time-related data you can take from all these. Scientific and engineering experiments, medical treatments, etc. For a scientific experiment, engineering experiments, those experiments also time-related data you have to extract. For any experiment, scientific related about COVID or anything, so time related data you have to extract for every 3 months. Last year analysis you have to take, you have to consider, and based on that you have to predict this year data, this year so that the exact example is that only. So for COVID calculations, last year in first wave, how many deaths you have seen, how many cases, in which area. So in which area you can get, you can see the observation statistics, you can analyze that. Based on that, you have to calculate for this year. So a time series database is also sequence database. Why? Because time is a sequence itself. So time, if you consider, the time is from morning to evening, morning to night, if you consider, that is in a sequence manner, sequence fashion. No? So we examine several aspects of mining time series databases, which focus on trend analysis and similarity sets. See here, that follows a particular trend. Trend analysis is the first one for time-related mining. Trend analysis is the first one, and second one is the similarity set. Trend analysis is nothing but particular trend we are following. So in this is the trend. See the figure in the graph, in the particular time the price is decreased. So in the particular time price is increased. On x-axis you have taken time, on y-axis you have taken price. So just you have taken all electronics stock, you have taken 10 days moving average. Okay, for that you considered in 10 days how the graph will be. So the graph, the price, so stock price, sometimes it is increasing, again decreasing, again increasing, again decreasing, like that. The trend, how the trend is in the particular 10 days duration, how the data will be. Okay, so that you have to calculate how the price of the particular product or stock market value changes. In stock market analysis also, in particular time, how the data will be, how the data goes, and major changes will come. That you will predict using trend analysis. A time series involving a variable Y representing daily closing price of a share in a stock market. Here, in stock market itself, that is the familiar example. Within fraction of seconds, you will observe lot of changes. Stock market is the main application for this time related. To understand time related mining, stock market is a very good example. So every day you can get the closing price. Okay, morning starting price, at the day end you will get some closing price. In between, meanwhile it will increase, decrease, like that it will fluctuate. No? Can be viewed as function time Ti. That is y equal to f of t. Here small t is the time. For that, how you are getting the result, that is the y equal to f of t. How we can study the time series data? So in general, two types are there: modeling time series and forecasting time series. So modeling is nothing but creating a rough sketch or creating an outline. So that is the modeling time series. In that particular time, how the data will be, how the changes will be, to gain insight that generates the time series. Insight view, what is happening, the insight for that view, we are considering modeling time series. Next, forecasting time series. In that particular time duration, so you have to predict, you have to forecast how the weather or how the market particular company stock value, like that you have to forecast. to predict the future values of the time series variables, what are the future values for this? Okay, based on the present values, we have to find out the future values. That is the forecasting. Okay, so that in for weather forecasting reports, we will see daily in news now. So how the weather will be predicted? So last 3 days. So how the weather will be? How the temperature will be based on that? How that feature 3-4 days. In your mobile itself, you are getting the app for weather prediction. Last 3 days, how the weather will be, next sunny, rainy or cloudy, for the temperature, you can predict the next day temperature or changes based on that last three days like that. So that is forecasting time series. The trend analysis consists of 4 major components for characterizing time series data. What are four major components? Trend or long-term movement, okay. Next, cyclic movements or cyclic variation, seasonal movements or seasonal variation, irregular or random movements. Okay, these are the four types. Okay, trend analysis is having 4 types. First one is the long-term movement. If you have seen departments or some fields that will have the movements very long term only. Okay, they will change only year wise. Okay, 2 years, 3 years, like that only. Long term movements will be there. General detection, in which the series graph is moving over a long interval of time, displayed by trend curve. Okay, typical methods are weighted moving average method. Least square method. These are the two methods we will use for this type of analysis. Okay, long term movements. In long interval only the changes will be done. Yeah. Mostly it is constant. In stock market itself, we are having two types of investments we can do. Okay, in first type of investment, you can do investment within a day. That is to be randomly, very, very dynamically changed. The value dynamically changes. If you put some 1 lakh rupees, that may go to 20,000, that may go to 20 lakhs, like that. Very change, severe changes will occur. So that is one type. The second type is that is consistent. So you just put on that, you just keep it, and after 2 years or 3 years, you will see that, okay, so the changes will be very minute. But the income will be constant. So income is not very high, not very low. So it is a constant. So cyclic movements or cyclic variation. These refer to a cycle that is long-term oscillations about trend line or curve. It is not a periodic. Cyclic movements is not a time oriented. Cycles need not necessarily follow exactly similar patterns after equal intervals of time. Okay. For example, this is a cycle. In this year, in this particular time, the changes will be like this. The price is like this. No? So in these 10 days, the price is like this. For example, chicken cost. You can take any, the gold or any other products, you can take anything. No? So just last year in this time, what is the price of chicken? Okay. So this year in this time, what is the chicken price? You compare, so the cycles may not be periodic. Okay. May or may not be periodic. So exactly last year, how the changes done, the same changes we cannot observe now here. Next, seasonal movements or seasonal variations. Seasonal movements you can find out easily. Why? Because based on season, some products will be purchased, right? Umbrella, raincoat. Okay, these all purchased in rainy season. Okay, so sweater, these all will purchase in winter season, like that. No? So AC, cooler in the summer season. Seasonal movement like that, based on the time, based on the season, the purchases will be there, the purchase ability of the particular people based on this season, the need, Christmas time. So then the sales will be more in particular time, in particular season, in Dasara, Christmas time, festival season. You are having offers also. Okay, in shopping malls you will see number of offers at the particular season time, the festival time. Sudden increase in sales of chocolates and flavors before Valentine's Day. For Valentine's Day, chocolate and flavors, that is one example. So for festivals, you can see cloth, sarees, the sales will be at a particular time, that will be increased definitely. Okay, so that is festival season. Next, irregular or random movements. These characterize the sporadic motion of the time series due to random or chance events. This is very rare. Irregular, the name itself indicates it is not regular. So if you consider labor disputes in any company, flood change, so any earthquake change, these are irregular. These movements we not consider. Why? Because in this year, any flood came at a particular time or any cyclone came, next year at the same time, that may or may not come. If it came also, that is not that much intensity. In this year it is having that much intensity, we may not expect in next year, like that. The announced personal changes within companies, okay? So these all are the general data. If you observe, time related mining is a general topic. These are no need to be technical, technically go into further. Just this is the all application, the entire application is about general. But we will apply mathematical formulae, graph for this for mining and use the different types of strategies. Okay, that we will see here. Okay, so these are the different types, four types. The in real time itself you can understand easily, no? So these are all four types you will see outside. Okay, in shopping malls, supermarkets, you will see regression analysis. See here, regression. What is meant by regression? Regression is a continuous variable. The continuous variable age will change year by year. Okay, next, salary will change. Age is a continuous variable, salary is a continuous variable, any length or any price of a particular place, area, that will vary. Okay. So regression analysis is a popular tool for modeling time series. In the point of view of time, the data change is continuously. That's why regression analysis is a popular tool for a time related data. Okay. So regression means the name itself indicates it is a continuous variable. Regression is a continuous variable. Time also continuous parameter. Based on the time, we have to evaluate the thing. That is not in a particular time. That is a continuous thing. Okay. So for every periodic time, you have to calculate that. The trend, cyclic, seasonal, irregular. These are the four types we have seen now. These movements are represented with the variables T means trend, T means cyclic, S means seasonal, I means irregular. So four types of movements we have seen now. So in time related mining, according to time, in real time you will see these four variables. The time series variable Y can be modeled as the variable we can find out by using product of four variables. You have to multiply these four and you can get the Y value. So that is Y equal to T into C into S into I. Okay, this is the four multiplication is nothing but the Y value. So how we can determine the trend of the data? So for determining the trend of the data, we are having the formulae, we are having the procedure. So that we will see. A common method is to calculate moving average of order n as the following sequence of arithmetic means. So you have to calculate mean by moving and moving itself from first item to nth item. second item to n plus 1th item, third item to n plus 2 item. The items, the y value will also change here. You observe the y we calculated here, na? Y can be calculated by multiplying all these. Why? Because the movements will be, the movements have to be taken in all aspects. For an item, that may be trend or long term movement, that is that may be cyclic movement, that may be seasonal movement, that may be irregular movement. Okay. So different types of changes you can observe. Now that's why the moving average you have to calculate first from y1 to yn, y1 plus y2 plus y3 and so on, yn by n. Next y2 to yn plus 1 by n. Next y3 to yn plus 2 by n. Like that you have to calculate the moving average from y1 to yn. So next just moving, next just move. Then what happened? y1 already over. Next y2 to yn plus 1. For that you have to calculate mean. Next y3 to yn plus 2 and so on. Every time one item will arrange, no? One for one particular item you calculate y value. So for that y value considered, and from y1 to yn you calculate the mean. Next y2 to you have to calculate the mean, y3 to calculate, that's like that. The resulting sequence is called weighted moving average of order n. This is the weighted moving average of order n. For each one we are having the weight, that is represented by using y. So we are calculating the average of n items. So every time it is moving, so some items are moving, some items are releasing, some items are updating. So like that we have to calculate the moving average. Other ways to estimate trend. So what is the other ways? So freehand method, approximate curve or line is drawn to fit a set of data based on user's own judgment. Next, this method is costly and not reliable. The freehand method, approximate curve. Next, user's own judgment, that is not reliable, that is not perfect. Okay, user only, user directly taking is not at all possible, and this is difficult also. Okay, the trend analysis, for trend analysis, we are having some experts. They will do the trend analysis properly. Okay, user's own judgment is not at all suitable. In stock market, you will observe, if you without any knowledge, if you invest your salary or some lakhs of rupees, definitely you will get lost in 99%. 1% chance is get to some profit or some amount of money, at least the interest amount of money you may or may not get. So you have to take experts are there for stock market analysis. So their suggestions only work mostly. So not 100% we can say, but mostly their suggestions will work. They will analyze the stock market, they will analyze the companies, they will analyze the growth of the products. So they will analyze the outside environment usage in real time, the people usages and people purchasing ability. So in this season, in recession time, the people purchasing ability will fall down. Okay? So these all can be predicted. Other ways to estimate trend is this one. So this is not reliable. An alternative is the least squares method. Then we consider best fitting curve. So when we consider best fitting, means we have to consider all the points. Mostly you have to go through all the points, you have to cover all the points. But the graph should not be go with each and every point. It has to go in a way such that it has to complete maximum points. It has to cover maximum number of points. In a freehand, if you have taken, that has to cover maximum number of points, that is the best fitting curve. Time series forecasting and finds a mathematical formula that will approximately generate historical patterns in the time series. So this is a mathematical formula. Just you will apply a mathematical formula we can generate the historical patterns, last 10 years of data, last 5 years of data, last 2 years of data, you can get using mathematical formulas. It is easy to make long-term or short-term predictions of future values. You can, sometimes you have to go for a long-term, for coming 5 years, what is the sales? For coming 10 years, what is the sales? So, or we have to predict some time for one more next month, next 2 months, 3 months, how the sales will be, that you have to predict, that is a short-term prediction. Like that, you are having long-term prediction and short-term prediction. The ARIMA is a method, okay, that can be used for the prediction. Auto-regressive integrated moving average. So this is the auto-regressive integrated moving average. So this is a way moving average to calculate the moving average itself. This method used, this is also called as Box-Jenkins methodology. The scientist name itself, Box-Jenkins. So he proposed this method, that's why it is a Box-Jenkins method. Okay, for forecasting, ARIMA method is weighted average. You will calculate the weighted average, moving average. You will calculate and you will proceed that. This is about the trend analysis. I hope you understood clearly about trend analysis. The trend analysis is purely based on the time regarding different aspects, that may be cycle, that may be trend, that may be seasonal, that may be earthquakes like that, irregular floods, or corona, COVID situations like that, any unexpected things. No? So those all different types of trend analysis. Next, time series data, second type is similarity testing time series analysis. Similarity test. What is similarity test? Unlike normal database queries, we find data match the given query exactly. Similar data you have to find out. Okay. That data sequences that differ only slightly from the given query sequence. You have given some sequence. The time sequence, 8 a.m., 8:30, 8:40, like that we have given. That time series has to be mostly satisfied. That is, 8:30, 9:40 you given means 8:35, 9:40, like that. No? So slight modifications, they differ only slightly. That is also acceptable. That is similarity set. Subsequent matching and whole sequence matching. Subsequent is nothing but if you have taken morning to night, if you, 12 hours you have taken, after 8 a.m. particular event occurred 9 a.m. only. So that is 8 a.m., 9 a.m. For today, the series will be 8, 9, 9:30, 10, 10:30. Like that, the series is there. Next is considered, then also, you are taking continuous data, no? So then the 8 a.m. 9 a.m. repeated second time also, that is nothing but subsequent. The entire sequence is not repeated, only 8 9 a.m. with two variables only, with two points of time only repeated. That is a subsequent matching. Next, whole sequence matching time, a set of sequences in S that are similar to each other. Set of sequences in S. So set of sequences in S that are similar to each other, the entire sequence. You have taken above, you have taken from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. you have seen the entire brace, S value is there. No? S value is a sequence. If that is completely repeated, that is whole sequence matching. Only some points of time, 8 a.m., 9 a.m. repeated. Within that, it is a subsequent. The whole process repeated, it is a sequence matching, whole sequence matching. Similarity sets in time series analysis is useful for financial market analysis, medical diagnosis, etc. Okay. Similarity sets is useful for these. For financial market, if you have to analyze financial market, the analysis similarity test can be useful. At the last year or period, last 10 days, okay, how the finance changes will be, financial market, money related, you can analyze that. Analysis will be useful mainly in medical diagnosis. Example, we also given a cardiogram analysis like that. The patient health point of view. So, in this particular season, in this particular time, okay, how the changes will occur. Like that, the predictions will be. I mean, the predictions are time-based here. The patient will occur in this particular winter season. You observe, in particular winter season, you will see mostly flu fever. All flu fevers will come in winter season only. Okay, so the COVID is completely different. This is a regular process that we are doing. But you can observe some diseases that will come in rainy season. Some fevers will occur. So every year in that particular season, you will observe that. So winter season, some occur. They will be in every winter season if temperature reaches to particular degree Celsius, then we will get the diseases like that. That is a similarity set. Okay. Next, data reduction transformation technique. I already told you, regarding to time, there is a huge amount of data. We are having CBs of terabytes of data, not only GBs, terabytes of data. So if you have to mine any data, if you have to retrieve any data, if you go through entire terabyte, then how much time it will take? It will take a lot amount of time now. So that's why time complex issue arises now. Here data reduction is necessary. Time series data mining, in that data reduction, data transformation is very, very needed. Why? Because time series is a huge amount of data, vast amount of data. That amount of data you cannot directly apply, you cannot directly retrieve entire amount of data, you cannot directly fetch on entire data warehouse or entire database. Huge amount of data is there, you cannot directly do that. What you have to do, you have to reduce the data. What is the other thing? You have to transform the data. Either you can select a particular portion, or you can decrease the size using some method. Content will not change, size will decrease. Okay, due to tremendous size, high dimensionality of time series data, data reduction often serves as the first step in time series analysis. Data reduction leads to not only much smaller storage space, but also much faster processing. So in data reduction, what happens? You will decrease the space, okay? And also when you decrease the space, automatically the processing will be high. But you have to see both. You have to decrease the storage space. The space has to be decreased. Okay, it has taken 1 GB, for example. How, say 500 MB, how you can decrease the data? How you can reduce the data? How the processing, what are the different processing methods to retrieve the data fastly? It is faster processing. Major strategies for data reduction include attribute subset selection, dimensionality reduction, numerosity reduction. These are the three methods for data reduction. First one, attribute subset selection. In a large amount of variables, a large amount of attribute, number of attributes, you have to consider some attributes, some properties of an object only you have to consider. So that is attribute subset selection. Okay, automatically if you are selecting only relevant thing, what happens? Relevant attributes only, subset only you have taken. Automatically the time will be reduced. The searching time will be reduced. The storage space will be reduced. Okay, so the attribute subset, you have to select attribute subset. That is one reduction. dimensionality reduction, which typically employs signal processing techniques. Dimensionality reduction, you have to reduce the dimension. That is also one thing. Next, numerosity reduction, the values you have to reduce, smaller representations, histograms, clustering, sampling, using the techniques so you have to represent numerically less values you have to use. So dimensionality reduction is our major concern. In these three attribute subset, numerosity reduction, dimensionality, three are there, but our major concern is dimensionality reduction. Okay, several dimensionality reduction techniques are there. How to reduce the dimensions means, here the I represented with red circle. Now why? Because dimensionality reduction is main thing for us. Okay, we are using several dimensions to represent the data for storing large amount of data. Large amount of data cannot be stored in less dimensions. Okay, you have to use multi-dimensional data, multi-dimensional storage you have to use. So these are the techniques when you go with dimensionality reduction. These are the techniques you will use: discrete Fourier transform, discrete Wavelet transform, singular value decomposition based on principal component analysis. Principal component analysis means the name itself indicates very, very important components only you will take and analyze. What are the major changes? You will only consider those. Random projection based techniques. These all are dimensionality reduction techniques. Okay. Similarity search method. Trial based approach to similarity search was pioneering with some limitations. It uses Euclidean distance as a similarity measure, which is sensitive to outliers. So it uses Euclidean distance. We have seen already Euclidean distance. Manhattan distance, Minkowski distance, these are three distances you have seen already, no? We have to use here Euclidean distance. We have to calculate the Euclidean distance. Based on that, we have to find out whether the variables are similar or not similar, and what are the outliers, how to detect the outliers. These all things you have to find out by using Euclidean distance. Just you have to calculate the Euclidean distance for all the elements based on the distance value, the Euclidean distance value. You have to find out the similar values and dissimilar values. What are the outliers? Here, dissimilar means outliers, far away from the other elements. Those are the outliers. This is sensitive to outliers. That is one property of this. Euclidean distance, if you have taken, based on that, if you have divided, based on that, if you have searched the data, na, what the problem is, it is sensitive to outliers. This compares even if there are differences in baseline, scale, and with gap. Okay. So, you can observe the baseline, scale, and with gap. Here, in figure, you can observe. First figure, original sequence, removing gaps, okay. Next, offset translation, amplitude scaling, these you can observe. The baseline, the scale, and how was the gap, you can observe in figure. The smaller the distance between two sets of time series data, the more similar are two series. If the distance between two sets of time series of data is very small, then the more similar are two series. The two series are more similar. Why? Because here the main focusing is on only distance. Here we are treating the similarity as the distance. Okay, smaller the distance, those are more similar, higher similarity. Those are far away means that is the lower similarity. Dissimilarity is high. However, we cannot directly apply the Euclidean distance. Instead, we need to consider differences in baseline and scale of two series. So we will not apply directly the Euclidean distance. Okay, we will calculate, but will not directly apply. What you will do, first you will do differences between baseline and scale of a two series. That you can see in the figure. In figure you can observe some two series are there, S and T. Okay, two sequences are there. In these two sequences, how the difference will be? Okay, so first you have to remove the gap. Okay, then you have to analyze how compare the sequences. So in some O2, some middle point, and some middle point to next, that is S1. First difference is S1, second difference is S2. Those you have to compare with the T1 and T2, as shown in figure. Transformation in the formula, following formula, xi dash equal to xi minus mu by sigma. So this is the formula to find out the transformation xi minus mu by sigma. Mu is mean value. Here what is meant by mu? Mu is nothing but mean value. Always mu is a mean value anywhere. X and the sequence x, sigma is the standard deviation of x. Okay, sigma is standard deviation. So that's why for transformation we have to calculate the mean value and the standard deviation value of x. Okay, for a sequence x you have to calculate the mean value and standard deviation, then you have to substitute those values. Then you will get, for each and every element, you will get the transformation. How can subsequent matching be performed to allow such differences? So users are expected to can specify parameters such as sliding window size, the maximum gap, matching fraction, and so on. You observe the figure, in this figure, what are the original sequences? S1, S2, these are the sequences. Gap is a given. Okay, here given is a gap. So second sequence, that is a P sequence. In the P sequence, P1, P2 are there, no? S1, S2 are compared with P1 and P2, as shown in the figure. Original sequence, this is the original sequence. If you have taken, what is the first step you have to do? You have to remove the gap. From S1 to S2, there is a gap. Gap we can observe, that gap you have to remove. Again from T1 to T2, in that also you have some gap, no? That gap you have to remove. Then what you have to do, sequence S, sequence T, offset transformation. So offset transformation, so S and T you have to compare. So how the transformations will be, those transformations you can calculate already. I told you that the formula xi dash equal to xi minus mu by sigma. Mean value you have to calculate for the sequence, and standard deviation value you have to calculate, and you have to substitute for each and every element. From 1 to n element, xi, x suffix I equal to 1 to n, x1, x2, x3, and so on, xn, you have to calculate, no? So for those values, x1 dash, x2 dash, x3 dash, x1 dash equal to x1 minus mu by sigma, x2 dash equal to x2 minus mu by sigma. For each and every element, you can find out the transformation using this formula. Similarity test can be performed by following steps: atomic matching, window switching, subsequent order. These are the three methods for performing similarity check. Okay, so this is about the time series data. You can observe clearly here, S1 compared with T1. So S1, T1. S1 represented with thick line, T1 represented with dotted line, the curve, dotted curve. Okay. Subsequent matching here, you can observe S2, T2 matched as shown in the figure. S2 is thick line, next the thick curve, T2 is the dashed curve. So those are two you can observe in figure 2. Okay, so atomic matching, window matching, window stitching, and the subsequent ordering. These are the steps you have to follow. Okay, this is the figure changes you can observe, and how S1, P1, S2, P2 are matched, how much they are matched, that you can observe using the following figure. Okay, so that is about time series data. So social network analysis is the next topic. So social network analysis we will see in next session. Okay.